how-tos.
You want to keep your sketch relatively light, because a lot of times if you're painting over these pencil lines, you can smudge the pencil lines into the paint, which is not typically a desirable look. The way that I sketch underneath a painting is, I call it topographically sketching. Basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna circle the high points of the face, and then circle the mid-tones, and then circle the dark points of the face. That helps me, when I'm painting, lay down my colors in the right area. This part, for example, is gonna be darker than the rest because it's her eye, which is a dark brown. So I sort of just shaded in lightly so that while I'm doing it, it makes the depth of the sketch make more sense to me. There's no need to sketch in fine details of any feature on the face because, like I said, it's just gonna be covered up. But I like to sort of circle or highlight the dark area. So right here, she's got a fold of the eyebrow. So we're gonna basically just outline with the pencil. Also circle the highlighted areas. And by circle, I mean outline in the shape that it will be on the painting. I always darken up the eyebrows because it helps me keep it organized. Like I said, you don't want to put too many dark areas of pencil onto the sketch, but you have more leeway on the dark areas of the face because the black paint will absorb any of the graphite that could potentially get in. Then we just darken this eyebrow, and then underneath the eye, there's always gonna be a dark area, so we're just gonna outline that. I make sure to section in the highlights of the eyes. So then we're gonna jump down to the nose, make sure we have the nostrils in place exactly where we want them. For these large planes of the face, I look at my reference photo and I note where the high points of the face are. So for example, she has this highlight on her forehead, so I'm just gonna block it in loosely. And then over here, it gets a little bit darker, so there's a mid-tone. And then over here, it gets a little bit darker in her hairline. And then her hair begins here. Also over here, this is the darker point. So I circle the mid-tones, sort of make some loose outlines, and then back down to the nose. Definitely, this is your chance to make sure that all of your shapes are right and proportionate to each other. There's always an area of highlight on the nose. So I'm gonna go ahead and circle that, and then you've got an area of shadow right here, the bridge of the nose. I'm gonna jump over to the other eye really quick, just darken the pupil so that it's clear when we're painting where we're gonna be putting that eye. This area is very dark because it's on the shaded side of her face, so I'm gonna go ahead and darken that up. There's no need to sketch in the individual hairs of the eyelash or the individual eyebrow hairs or anything like that, because those are all details that come in when you're painting. Sometimes I'll darken this outline just so it's clear to me. This side of the nose is in shadow, so I'm gonna sort of color that part in. The center of the lips is one of the only purely black parts of a face, so we're gonna go ahead and put that line in. I will circle the different tones of the lips. So here we've got a more purple tone. And then here we've got a little bit more of a red tone, leaving up here for highlights. And then over here it gets darker, and you can add a few contour lines if that helps you. We've got another dark shadow right here. A little bit of darkness over here. And then this entire corner of the face is sort of in shadow. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a shadow right there. We've got a little darkness there in the corner of the mouth. I really want to make sure I get the cheek highlight right. So you circle that light space in the exact shape. We got another little highlight there. A little bit of contour of the cheekbone. And then here you see a lot of like the same color, so I'm gonna pretty much leave that alone. The neck, usually there's always this triangular shadow on the neck. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and shade it in. And then she has a bit of a shadow here as well. One thing that is very dark in the painting is her hair. There's no need to color that in or to sketch it, because most of that is fine detail work. I find myself doing a lot of coloring on the ear so that I can get the dark portions right. Everyone has this area here, which is really dark because it's the ear canal, and then this area is a Y shape, and then it's a G right here. You can kind of see. That's about as detailed as I'll do any part of the face. For demonstrating purposes, I have kind of made these lines pretty dark. I would suggest making them lighter rather than darker if you're doing this underneath a painting, especially if you're using acrylic paint of any kind.